pass these capes around. Everyone pick a feather for your size 14 or 16, which is what we're doing. Caddis, but pick a feather off any one of these capes is fine. They're all, of course, Wedding Farms capes. Yeah, those three. Okay, while you're picking that feather, I'm just going to show you how I prepared this feather. Notice how it's kind of translucent? This is going to be the wing of the fly, basically, a down wing across the top of the caddis. This is a California Valley quail. You could probably get the same thing with a mountain quail, but what I really like about this is when it's prepared, it's like having two little eyes on top. But when you look at it from the bottom, it's even more pronounced. Okay? So all I'm going to do is take a little head cement, put it between my fingers, like so. I'm just going to pull this through my fingers. And all I'm really trying to do is flatten that out just a little bit so it's a little less translucent, but you still can see the barring on the bottom. That's what the fish is going to be looking at. That's what you're going to see from the top. All right, I'm going to start, whether you're using tan or olive, either one. If you need dubbing, let me know, guys. Okay, I'm just going to attach my thread. I'm going to attach it at the 1/3 position, which is where my wing set's going to be. And I'm going to take the thread all the way back to the barb. Stop. And make one extra turn just to cover up that little piece that I trimmed off. Just throw it on the floor. Okay, I'm just going to grab a little dubbing. I like to take the dubbing out of the end of the bag, and I like to pull it so it's in a long, very thin amount. Thereby, you end up creating what's called a noodle out of it. I'm just going to... Can you actually see this on the camera okay?
Yeah.
Because I feel like I'm flying blind a little bit.
You can look back and take a look. It looks good.
Okay, I'm just going to connect this, and I'm going to tie this in, and I'm going to go all the way up. Just going to dub it. Fairly tight, and when you let go, it's going to be a little bit loose, but it should still be fairly tight. I'm going to go all the way up to my basic wing set position. I'm going to go back about 2/3 of the way, and then I'm going to come back forward again. So I'm creating a little bit of a taper in the fly, and stop. Cool. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this feather. I'm just going to pull a few of the fibers back. Not a lot, because remember this has got head cement on it. Just to clear it out a little bit. Like so. I want this to go just beyond the end of the body. I'm going to set it right on top, a quarter turn towards me, and I'm going to tie this in. Loose wrap. And you're going to say, oh, but it's going to go around the hook. Well, I'm going to keep wrapping back so I get right on top of the body a little bit right here. And it's not going to go anywhere. What you want to do is you want to get this to lay back just a little bit. Now, one of the things you'll notice on the feathers that I gave to you, they're going to be a little bit crooked. You look at this straight on, it's kind of curved. You want to tie it in so that curve is basically gone. That's going to be your tie-in point, basically. A couple ways you can do it. If your feather doesn't work, I have more feathers up here. Like this one didn't work the way I wanted it to. So I'm just going to back it off. I'm going to take this feather, I'm going to cut it to shape. I'm just cutting a little bit of a triangle in here at the very end of it. Place it on top. Okay, there we go.
Much better. Did you put some head cement on that one?
Yeah, these are all head cemented right here. All the ones I handed out to you guys.
Okay, you head cemented just the tip of it or the whole thing?
I do the whole feather, basically. And trim away what I don't need. So when I go around, just to show you what this looks like now, so you can see it from the bottom. See those little black tips in the back there? It's like a really cool little trigger. That's why I like to use this quail feather. Okay. We're going to take our, in this case, I'm going to use a Cree. I'm going to find a sweet spot. Clear it out. Tie it in dry fly style. Okay, for all you caddis fishermen, where will you fish this fly?
In the water?
Anywhere I can float it.
Mainly in tailouts, in softer water, when you've got a situation where, you know, the fish are really taking a look at it, and it's slow water, and it's not very riffly, and they keep rising, but you just can't get them to hit, that's when you want to use this fly. Because what we're going to do is we just tied our hackle in. We're going to hackle this forward about 5 or 6 wraps. What I prefer that you use is light ginger or medium ginger, and if you want to, barred ginger for a little bit of color in the fly. The capes that went around should be light bar or medium barred ginger, and dark barred ginger. Okay, I'm just going to whip finish this. Oh, I forgot my whip finisher. I know there was something I forgot. Something Andy Puyan showed me is I love to have this kind of head cement with this kind of head cement applicator. You guys ever seen this before? Okay.
Only on my wife's nail glue.
Okay. I never have to take the lid off, which means I never leave it off so it dries out, right? Also, I have to apply thinner to this about once every 5 months. When I pull it out of here, there's a little bead that you'll see right on it that'll collect right on the end of the needle, and I can just touch it right in the front here, and I'm done. What I do... These you can get at, there's a place called Silks in Berkeley. It's, all this is a bone sewing needle, on the other end. Just like you do a fly rod guide, where you do the wraps. I just do 8 or 10 wraps down, measure for height. And you can see that right on the top here, it forms a little glue kind of stop. So it will never evaporate on you either. If you knock it over on the table, it doesn't come out. Okay? So it's a little trick, but it's really, really nice when you're using this when you're tying flies, because if I'm doing a really tiny fly and I want to do something really, really small, instead of that big drop on the end I might want on a size 12 or 14 dry fly, I can turn this sideways and the drop becomes smaller. And I can apply it right on the edge and just get a little bit of head cement on there. Okay? Just, I'm trying to show you a couple little tricks at the same
time.
What's that?
You drill the cap to fit that needle?
Yeah, what I do is I just get my standard drill, I hold this thing up, I get my drill bits, and I try to get one that's just a little bit smaller than this is, drill it out, and then make sure that I just work it around until this thing comes in and out fairly easily. So that's basically the California Quail Caddis. You guys know these tricks, I'm sure, but if I want this to sit up, and back, great. If I want it to sit right in the surface film, I'm just going to go right in from the front and clip a little V out on the bottom. And this thing will just sit right flat in the surface film with a hook in the water. Yeah. Okay, I'll pass this one around, but who gets these when we're done? You do? So I'll send him the other way because he may not give it up.